Hey everybody, it's Phil with Behringer. How you doing today? Welcome to Music Studios. I want to talk to you today about miking an electric guitar amp, okay? There's a lot of different ways to do it, so let's talk about them. So there are a lot of ways to mic a guitar amp. You can use one mic, two mics, ribbon mics, condenser mics, dynamic mics. There's a lot of different ways to achieve a really good sound. What I'm going to talk about today is one of the most common setups and the quickest setups to get a decent guitar sound out of an electric guitar amp. Typically, when you go to festivals and things like that and you walk on stage, you might see a microphone hanging off of an amplifier off of the front and they just have it draped over the front of the speaker. Well, in reality, on a typical dynamic microphone, the pattern is cardioid, so it's actually going around from the front of the capsule and there's only a little bit being picked up by the side. So if you put it hanging on a speaker, there's not a lot of signal that's getting picked up. There's some and enough in a lot of cases, but not good tone most of the time. So you want to have the microphone, actually if this was the face of the speaker, this neck, you want to have it in one of two typical positions. Either on axis, which is parallel to the speaker, like right in front of the speaker, or you want to have it off axis, which is 45 degrees off of straight up, so it'd be 45 degrees canted to the speaker, off axis. Typically, the on-axis is going to be a brighter, more mid-rangey sound, and the off-axis is going to be a little warmer, a little more airy sound. So that's kind of the theory of just quickly miking a guitar amp. So let's talk about where to put the mic and how to actually, you know, physically do what we're talking about here. So when typically miking an amp, you want to know where the speaker is, okay? And in multiple speaker cabs, like a 412 cabinet or a 212 cabinet, you might actually like the way one speaker sounds versus the rest of them. So you can listen to each of them and see which one you really like and then mic that one. Like I said, on axis, off axis, let's talk about on a typical combo amp like this, you know, a great sounding amplifier, we want to find where the speaker is. Two ways to quickly do it. One is to shine a flashlight through the grill so that you can actually see where the speaker is, because that's important to know, because not all amplifiers have the speaker in the middle. Some are offset, so you want to kind of compensate for that. But in this amplifier, it's in the middle. But what I'll do is I'll kind of roll my hand just gently against the grill and feel the outside of the frame of the speaker, okay? And then that way, I can kind of tell, okay, that's the width of the speaker. This must be halfway. That's the cone, the center of the cone, and this is the edge of the cone. Typically for me, I like having the microphone halfway between the center of the speaker and the edge of the speaker, and then deciding whether I want it on or off axis from there. So if I'm feeling along the amp here and I go, okay, this must be the middle, I want to have this mic a little tucked in, maybe here-ish. And a couple inches, sometimes you like it right against the grill of the microphone, sometimes you want it a couple inches back, you have to see which sounds best. That's the thing about miking a guitar amp. There's a lot of different ways, and if I'm doing a jazz session with this amp, I might mic it differently than if I was doing a blues or rock or country or heavy metal session with the same amplifier, because there's going to be a wide array of tones that I can get just by where I put the microphone, regardless of what the guitar player is doing. Just by where I put the mic, I can change the tonality of it, what gets recorded. So typically, I'm just going to start here, and that's a good starting place. So this is a recording of the straight on, just on axis, dynamic microphone on a speaker. All right, now we're going to take it and we're going to make this now, we're going to change it to off axis. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the microphone, I'm going to point it about 45 degrees in and move the mic in because now it's changed angle. Yeah, now let's try that. Same exercise. Just now with the microphone at 45 degrees off axis. That's good. Let's put it back on axis. So you should kind of hear that the on-axis is going to be a little bit more mid-rangey and the off-axis is going to be a little more warm and bottom end and a little more air. So depending on what sound you want for that session, you're going to want to place the mic accordingly. Now some people will take this microphone and say another microphone, like a ribbon mic or something like that, and put it next to it and get two different sounds. Be careful of that, only in the respect to be careful for phase. Microphones get closer together, you can have phase issues, but you can solve for that as well. So this is just a typical setup on how to quickly mic an electric guitar amp for live or in the studio. I hope you picked up a couple of tips from this. For more information and media, you can always come find us at Behringer.com. Thanks for joining us here at Music Studios.